رمضان هل هلاله وظلاله.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Honorable viewers to ITV Soul Food, Subhanallah. When Ramadan has got its blessings, has got its deep reflection, deeper meaning, when Ramadan calls for a month of change, a month that mankind was looking forward to recharge the soul, to refresh my relationship with Allah, to reflect deeply who really am I, to have a more family time, to more be of sharing and caring to my family members and the community at large, and to open our hearts to the less fortunate. As it is known that our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was the most generous during this month of Ramadan. In fact, my dear viewers, when he was asked, "Ayyu sadaqati afdal," which charity at what time is the best to give? And he said, "Afdalu sadaqa fi Ramadan." The best of charity is in this month of Ramadan. And do we know, if you look at the pious people of yesteryear, the likes of Hamad bin Salama, radiallahu anhu, a famous muhaddith, he would feed himself 50 people daily during the month of Ramadan. Why? They knew the magnitude of feeding the people. It's not much measured of how long you stood on this musalla in prayers for the whole night to get the Laylatul Qadr, but it's more measured when you fed that 50 people that was poor and needy, that all that you did done here just goes up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah give us understanding. When Hamad bin Salama, subhanallah, when Az-Zuhri radiallahu anhu, he used to practice these two qualities in Ramadan, tilawatul Quran and it'amut ta'am, feeding the poor and needy. He would only do this, that two qualities. In fact, when Ramadan would begin, Imam Malik rahmatullah alayhi radiallahu anhu would stop his hadith, the famous Imam Malik, par excellence, the best in when it comes to the knowledge of hadith in Madinatul Munawwara, but he would stop his lessons of hadith, of the prophetic words, and he'd concentrate only on the direct words of Allah in the Quran. And he would say, this is the month of the Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. A month. Allah never mentioned any other month so clear in the Quran, which shows the highlights, the greatness of this month. رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, in which Allah brought down the complete holy book to all of mankind as guidance. وَبَيِّنَاتْ مِنَ الْهُدَىٰ, and much clearer guidance you'll find in every word for all times and for all places. وَبَيِّنَاتْ مِنَ الْهُدَىٰ وَالْفُرْقَانِ, and it is the criteria between right and wrong. At any given moment, the Quran challenges mankind, bring your minds, bring your intelligentsia, and bring the likes to see the greatness and the power of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved honorable viewers to ITV, Moulana Zakaria rahmatul alayh, he compiled a book, one of the great awliya of Allah, great scholars of Islam, well known that his book in fact has sold in the hundreds of thousands, and his book is well read in different languages. 700 pages of his book that he compiled, Fada'ilul As-Sadaqat. I would love you to, at home as a family, sit at least 5 minutes. Sit at least 5 minutes or 7 minutes and read a hadith regarding the greatness and the excellence of charity and the heed for neglecting your zakat, etc. Now Allah Ta'ala linked sadaqah with salah in many verses. يُكِيمُ الصَّلَاةُ وَمِمَّا رَزَقَنَاهُمْ يُنْفِكُونَ, to highlight to us the importance of charity, of looking after the creation of Allah, you will find the Creator Allah. And therefore, Ramadan with all its merit, Rasul said, Sadaqatul Fitr A'mal Mu'allaq Bayna Sama'i Wal Ard. That your fitrah is suspended between the heavens and the earth, all your good deeds, until you take out your fitrah and you pay for the poor and the needy. And in so doing, Allah then raises up all your good deeds. That's why Umar ibn Abdul Aziz radiallahu anhu, he said, Salah takes you halfway to Jannah, and your fasting takes you to the door of the king. But your charity, it makes you enter Jannah. And the charity at the end, it boasts to all the other deeds, and it says, Ana afdalukum, I'm the best of the rest. That is it. And why is it called sadaqah? Because the individual gives it from inside his heart. He doesn't give it for show. He doesn't want his name attached anywhere. It is only, la nuridu jaza'a wa la shukura. We don't want any gratitude and thanks of man. We want a direct of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in fact, when you are putting something in the hand of a poor as he takes it, you look how he takes it. It is actually falling in the hands of Allah. And Allah loves that. Ma naqasat sadaqa min mal. Whatever you are giving, you don't minus. You only add up. Because Allah ta'ala only gives you back. Subhanallah. Anas radiallahu anhu, he said, a person came to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of the tribe of Tamim. And they said, oh beloved Rasul of Allah, and this shows us, if you are doubting, you don't know how to work out your zakat, you go to a learned scholar that has the knowledge of the chapter of zakat, and you ask him, because that's the sunnah of sahaba, they went to the Prophet ﷺ for guidance. And they said, oh messenger of Allah, inni dhu malin kathir wa dhu ahlin wa mal. I am a possessor of a lot of money, alhamdulillah ta'ala shukr, Allah has blessed me with abundance. And this year I'm just feeling hallelujah, just everything is going bonanza crazy in my life. And not only that, subhanallah, Allah's blessed me with big family and they're all well off, alhamdulillah. Fakhbirni, I need your guidance. Kaifa asna wa kaifa umfik. This is my amount I have. Please give me direction. This was the person's iman, his source of belief in Allah and his consciousness. That what consciousness of this month of Ramadan does to a person. And he asked the best person to guide him. And this person of taqwa, our beloved Rasul Sallam told him that take out zakat of your wealth. And when you are going to take out that zakat of your wealth, the 2.5%, what is going to do to your balance of your wealth? To tahiruka, it will cleanse your soul. And it will purify your life. And it will bond your family. There will be more blessings and muhabbat in the family. وَتَعْرِفْ حَقَّ الْمَسْكِينَ. And in so doing, you'll identify also who is the poor in your community, who is the widow in your community. You'll be shocked. You'll have 5 widows in your community and everyone looks a deaf ear to them. People are so busy in their own rat race, they haven't got time. And here you make that time. And in your own family, Rasulullah said, Wabda bi man ta'ul. Go and look up your aunt. Go and look up your uncle that's old. They cannot work anymore. And you can put something in their hands. So you recognize the rights of the poor. You recognize your neighbor. And recognize someone that came to you for a loan. And someone that's in a difficulty. And you help that person out. My honorable viewers, my honorable sisters in Islam, you know what your husband's earnings are. You know what his undertakings are. You need to encourage him, but encourage him with a beat. Making him a lekker fresh cream for tonight. Making him his lovely dessert for tonight. And then you tune him nice in his ear. My husband, you know what? Inshallah, may Allah Ta'ala give you a lot of abundance more, inshallah. But let us work out our zakat. Then Allah will give you also the rewards of that. You will see the muhabbat coming in your life. If you have misery in your life at this moment in time and things are going all like a roller coaster in your life, despite all the money and everything that luxury you have, then you need to look deep down into yourself, the story of this person of the Tamim tribe. Because indeed the Prophet ﷺ said, Man adda zakat malihi, the person that fulfills the zakat, faqad ذهب عنه شره. Immediately Allah removes all obstacles from you. Every obstacle of yours become a blessing in disguise when you take out your zakat. So purify your fast by discharging your duties. Pay your zakat, your sadaqah, your lillah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once reminded Aisha. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once reminded Aisha radiallahu anha. Ya Aisha, hibbil masakin, oh my beloved wife, love the poor. Qarribihim, go and take your zakat, go and take your lillah, your sadaqah, be close-knitted with the poor, so that Allah can be close to you on the day of Qiyamah. Allah loves the poor. You know that famous hadith, istat'amtuk, oh children of Adam, I was hungry, you never fed me. Oh Allah, how can we feed you? You are the Lord of the world. Allah say, if you went to that poor person and you gave him a parcel of fitra, you gave him a sadaqah, lillah, you would have found me there. Look where. Do you think Allah is only in your masjid? Alhamdulillah, I'm not saying don't go to the masjid. I'm not disencouraging you. But you'd find right there that poor person, you find the mercy of Allah. When the Rasulullah was asked, which is the best of Islam? He said, tuti'mu ta'am, feed the poor and needy. And then you spread salams to you, whether you know the person or you don't know the person. The best of deeds are those to put a smile on a poor person's face. When you are buying that person clothes for Eid, or you're removing some poverty from their homes, or you gave them some shoes to wear, or some clothing to cover their aura. More than half of the poor in the world is Muslims. Millions of Muslims are children. Thousands are daily dying from starvation. If you can feed 100 children, if you can't feed 100, feed one. Ta'arif haqq al-miskin, recognize today in this month of Ramadan, have a heart. Recognize the poor. And that sadaqah you will give, my beloved brother, it will remove 70 doors of your obstacles in your life. This is how merciful Allah is. Allah can help everyone. But He wants us to share in it as Banu Adam. I end off. Once Uthman radiallahu anhu heard there was no food left in the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He brought a fat sheep, flour and oil, and took it all to Aisha's house. And he said, O mother of the believers, let Rasulullah not share this with any other homes. I've already gone to them and gave every wife of the Prophet its fair share. Subhanallah. When the Prophet came home, he was so pleased that his son-in-law Uthman has done such a heart he has, that he has given everyone a share. I'm telling today to all the son-in-laws today, go and steal your father-in-law's heart, and go steal your uncle's hearts, and go take some to make shukr for Allah, and you see what you get back after Ramadan. The Prophet made this dua. Oh Allah, pardon you, for Uthman. Pardon your spouse. Pardon your children. Pardon your progeny till Qiyamah. Therefore, may Allah grant us that quality of generosity. Generosity is close to Allah, close to Jannah, close to good du'as of people, and far from the fire of Jahannam. Wa ma tawfiq illa billah. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
وظلاله وجماله رمضان رمضان هل هلاله وظلاله وجماله.